Hello everyone, today my video lecture is on fluid mechanics CE254, which is a course for civil engineering students, second year, third semester. This is Aman Jain, Assistant Professor, Department of Civil Engineering, Sir Padmanabhan Singhania, University, Udaipur. The contents of this, this presentation will be first of all, we will be covering some basic concepts of fluid mechanics. Then we will be knowing that what the fluid is, what is the definition of fluid. Then we will be jumping on to properties of fluid, mass density, weight density, and then we will cover pressure and its measurement. So let's talk about basic concepts of fluid mechanics. So before knowing fluid mechanics, one should know what the mechanics is. So mechanics is the oldest physical science that deals with both stationary and moving boundaries under the influence of forces. The branch of the mechanics that deals with the bodies at rest is called statics, and while the branch that deals with the bodies in the motion is called dynamics. There is a difference between statics and dynamics. There is fluid mechanics also. Fluid mechanics is for static fluids also. Fluid mechanics for dynamic fluid. There is another fluid mechanics for dynamics also. Fluid mechanics is the science that deals with the behavior of fluids at rest, that is fluid static, or in motion, fluid dynamics, and the interaction of fluids with solids or other fluids at the boundaries. A substance in liquid gas phase is referred to as fluid. So as we know that there are three phases, solid phase, liquid phase and gaseous phase. So apart from solid phase, liquid and gaseous phase is known as fluids, and distinction between solid and fluid is made on the basis of a substance ability to resist an applied shear, which is tangential stress that tends to change its shape. A solid can resist an applied shear by deforming its shape, whereas a fluid deforms continuously under the influence of shear stress, no matter how small its shape is. In solid, stress is proportional to strain. Yes, this is the important thing which is to be noted, that in solid, stress is proportional to strain, but in fluid, stress is proportional to the strain rate. So here, let's talk about the points. Although it is easy to compress a gas, whereas liquids are incompressible. A given of the liquid occupies a fixed volume that we all know very well, irrespective of the size and shape of the container. Like we are filling the water into the glass, it occupies the fixed volume in a glass. Okay, but unlike gas has no fixed volume and will expand continuously unless they are restrained by the containing vessel. For liquids, a free surface is formed in the volume of the container and greater than that of the liquid. A gas will completely fill any vessel in which it is placed and therefore does not have any free surface. It's like you see in the water bodies that this is a canal and this is the water level. Let's say this is the water level. So this surface is free surface. This level is known as free surface level. This is water canal and if we are taking an example of any glass, so let's say the water is filled up to here. This is the glass and this is canal. So if the water is filled up to here, so this surface will be free surface. Free surface is the surface which is in contact with the gaseous state. okay. But if any gas is filled into any container, no matter how what is the amount of it, it will be containing. So if I am closing this container from here, the molecules of the gas will be surrounded in the full complete vessel. If I can fill more molecules in it, more amount of gas in it, they will be get compressed and they will occupy the whole container. And if it will be, this is the container. So it was like that a gas will completely fill any vessel in which it is placed and therefore does not have any free surface. What are the properties of fluids? This is the important topic, that what are the properties of fluid. So what is the property? A characteristic of a system, any characteristic of a system is called a property. It may be either intensive, it may be or extensive. Intensive properties are mass independent, and which of that depends on the size of system are the extensive properties. And the state of system is described by its properties. So let's after knowing that what the properties are, let's discuss about the pressure. Some terms with some useful terms which will be which are very important related to this fluid mechanics subject. So let's first of all discuss about what the pressure is. Pressure P is the normal force exerted by a fluid unit area, which we are studying always. Fluid per unit area. So this is pressure and also pressure force. In SI system, the dimension of the pressure can be written as Newton per meter square. Let's have a look at the definition of density, then another property. The density of a substance is the quantity of matter contained in unit volume of substance. It is expressed in three different ways. Mass density is mass upon volume. Specific weight, which is rho into g. Relative density or specific gravity, which is specific gravity, is density upon density of water. This is density of standard liquid, and this is the density of liquid. And when it is the case of gas, we are taking the specific gravity. We are taking the specific gravity of rho upon rho air. We are taking this formula for gases, and we are using this formula for liquids. We are using this formula for liquids. Okay, so this is mass upon volume. This is specific weight. Specific weight is nothing but the weight upon volume. So it is the weight is your mass into mass upon volume. So it will be like. So this is the explanation of everything, and let's now come to the density, dimensions are ml minus 3, unit is kilo per meter cube. This is for mass density. Mass is measured in kilograms and volume is measured in m cube. So this is, the unit is like this. For the specific weight, the unit is Newton per meter cube. It's like I told mg upon that Newton per meter cube. The standard values for density of water and air are given as 1000 kilogram per meter cube and 1.2 kilogram per meter cube respectively. So this is the water and this value is for air. Respectively, many a times the reciprocal of mass density is called specific volume. So a specific volume is volume is the reciprocal of mass density, that is volume upon mass, that is 1 upon rho. So this is a specific volume. So these were all things. Now let's discuss the temperature. Temperature, it is the measure of hotness or coldness of the system in thermodynamic sense. It is the measure of internal energy of the system. Many times the temperature is expressed in the centigrade scale, that is temperature is measured in either centigrade or Kelvin, where the freezing and boiling point of the water is taken as 0 degrees Celsius and 100 degrees Celsius respectively. In SI system, the temperature is expressed in the terms of absolute value, Kelvin scale. That is, Kelvin scale is plus 273. So this is Kelvin scale, as we know, so this was the temperature. Viscosity is another important property of a fluid. Viscosity is this is Greek letter mu, it's the denotation of viscosity. When two solid bodies in contact moves related to each other, a friction force develops at the contact surface in direction of opposite to motion. The situation is similar when a fluid moves relative to a solid, or when two fluids move relative to each other. The property that represents the internal resistance of a fluid, to motion, that is fluidity, is called viscosity. It is much similar, as I said, that in fluids, that is in solids, it is friction, and in liquid or in fluids, it is termed as fluidity. It is either between the layers of same fluid or fluid or solid. It is fluidity or viscosity is one another same thing. The fluids for which the rate of deformation is proportional to the shear stress are called Newtonian fluids. So this is the Newton's law of viscosity, where tau is the shear stress which is directly proportional to the rate of deformation, rate of shear strain. The fluids for which the rate of deformation is proportional to the shear stress is called Newtonian fluids, and the linear relationship for a one-dimensional system is shown in the figure next one. The shear stress is expressed as mu du by d y, where d y is the shear strain rate. This is the shear strain this term is known as shear strain rate. This is dynamic viscosity. This is dynamic viscosity of the fluid. So I think it is clear. The formula is very much clear. This tau is equal to mu du by dy. So, and this is also known as Newton's law of viscosity. So those liquids which obey this law are called Newtonian fluids, and those liquids or those fluids which does not obey the Newtonian this Newton's law of viscosity are known as non-Newtonian fluids. There is yet another viscosity which is known as the kinematic viscosity, which will be discussing in this slide. The dynamic viscosity is a dimension. Dynamic viscosity is a dimension of ML minus 1 T minus 1. This is dynamic viscosity, and the unit of this viscosity is kilogram per meter second, or it is the SI unit is Newton second per meter square, or it is also termed as Pascal seconds, because Newton upon meter square second it is known as Pascals. The unit is known as Pascal. A common unit of dynamic viscosity is poise, which is equivalent to 0.1 Pascal second. Many a times the ratio of dynamic viscosity to density appears frequently, and this ratio is given name as kinematic viscosity. So this is very important term, where mu, the ratio of dynamic viscosity to the density, is known as nu, and it is represented by nu. This is the letter nu. It has got dimensions L2 T minus 1, and the unit of the stock, where one stock is equal to 0.0001 meters square per second. The typical values of kinematic viscosity of air and water at atmospheric temperature are 1.46 × 10⁻⁵ meters square per second, and 1.14 × 10⁻⁶ meters square per second respectively. This is the graph where let me have this. This is the shear strain rate du by dy, and this is the shear stress tau, which is tau, and this is the equation which we were talking about. We are starting from here. This is the line which shows ideal fluid when the fluid is ideal. Basically, ideal fluids are imaginary fluids which are not there. This line represents Newtonian fluids. I mean, these are fluids which obey this law. When this law is obeyed, the fluids are Newtonian fluids. When this law is not of it, the fluids are pseudoplastics or non-Newtonian fluids. This is Bingham plastic and this is plastic units. And this line shows solids. So this is the important relationship where variation of shear stress with the rate of deformation is explained. Let's now discuss the compressibility and bulk modulus. Compressibility is the reciprocal of bulk modulus of elasticity K, which is defined as the ratio of compressive stress to the volumetric strain. Now let us discuss what the vapor pressure is. Vapor pressure is defined as the pressure exerted by its vapor in phase equilibrium with its liquid at the given temperature when it is in equilibrium. For pure substance, it is same as the saturation pressure in a fluid motion. If the pressure at the some location is lower than the vapor pressure, bubbles start forming, and this phenomena is called cavitation because they form cavities in the liquid. Surface tension, another important property of fluid, which is known as surface tension, which is denoted by Greek letter sigma. This is sigma. When a liquid or gas or two immiscible liquids, immiscible means they are two that type of liquids which are not able to mix within each other. When a liquid or gas of two immiscible liquids are in contact, an unbalanced force is developed at the interface stretched over the entire fluid mass. The intensity of molecular attraction per unit length along any line in the surface is called surface tension. For example, in a spherical liquid droplet or droplet of radius r, the pressure difference delta p between inside and outside surface is given by 2 sigma upon r. In SI system, the unit and the dimension of the pressure can be written as Newton per meter and MT minus 2 respectively.